Hey guys, this is Alex from Tafoga Best. I recently got back from an absolute dream trip to Spain. It was unreal. And what I typically do for every single trip that I take is just create a really, really quick packing list. So I have ones for Italy, for 3 weeks in Europe on a carry-on, for the Pacific Northwest. So I'll have those linked below so you can check them out too. And specific to the region that we were in Spain, it's so hot that I really needed to kind of be strategic with my packing. And so today I thought I'd take you through really quickly what I packed, why I packed it, and also a couple tips on how to pack. So specifically in Andalusia, it's so hot, and most of Europe is really hot around this time, or at least the places that are popular tourist destinations, whether it's Rome or Paris. I picked a lot of options that were cotton or cotton blends. So this is a beautiful little strapless dress from Revolve. It fits like a dream. I got a size up so that it'd be really nice and oversized and hide my food baby. Unfortunately, it has kind of these tears as well that really do a great job of kind of just hiding everything, and if you're a sweaty mess, you're not gonna see it in this. This is another strapless number I packed from Revolve. A lot of my pieces are Revolve. They just have good travel pieces typically. It was nice to have these little pockets and a nice kind of relaxed silhouette. And again, this is also kind of a cotton blend, so really, really good for washing on the go. One of my tips is to wash with shampoo in a sink if you don't have laundry detergent, or if you're not an Airbnb that offers a washer dryer. So while I've really been on the off the shoulder train lately and really, really love them, especially for these kind of trips when you're wanting something with a more relaxed silhouette but want to show a little bit of skin still, it is important to have something like this that has a higher neckline and some sleeves. So this is a really great piece from Mango. I liked it because it was really easy to convert into a shirt if I wanted to wear it with pants. The reason why you should always have a piece like this is not only if you get burned and need to cover up here, but for visiting religious sites, whether it's a church or mosque or whatever else, it's the worst to kind of get turned away at the door because you're not dressed properly. So having an option like this that's still really breezy. So in a similar vein of kind of covering up and having some options both for religious sites and also if you get burned, this Aritzia number is so pretty. It's really breezy. I've worn this one in Greece as well. It serves me really well. I don't actually wear it that much at home for some reason, probably because Vancouver doesn't get too hot, but when I'm traveling, it just comes in handy like crazy. So it has these nice details here. So even in really hot destinations, I always pack a pair of jeans. I'll usually wear it on the plane on the way there, and if I want to wear it again during the trip, if I want to get plane smell out, then I'll do what I told you before about just shampooing it out in a sink or using a laundry service if my Airbnb happens to have one. But for a warmer place, nothing really beats white denim. I love these mauve jeans because they're not too thick, so they're quite breathable. There's no holes in it, so I felt really comfortable wearing this to the cathedral in Seville. So while I usually do more separates for my longer trips, so anything where I'm gone for 3 weeks, I'll usually do more kind of skirts and tops so I can mix and match a lot. But because Spain was so hot and I knew I was only gonna be gone for 1 week, I felt more comfortable just knowing that I could rewash a couple key dresses that were gonna really be comfy and cozy and appropriate for the heat. Having said that, it is always nice to have a couple separate options. So I packed this really lovely silk tank top from Aritzia, and then just a similar one in white. This piece is kind of my magic little piece. I've worn it on maybe like 4 different trips now. It gets so much use. It's a little strapless number from Aritzia. I believe it's called the Horatio dress. It's a great length. It's not too short. It's lined, which is always an asset when you're wearing white. Okay, so sun hats are absolutely critical. I know they're a bit harder to pack, and a lot of people will just wear them on the planes, but then you run the risk of stepping on them underneath your seat or having them crushed by baggage in the overhead compartments. So what I do is I always just pack them with socks or underwear or other smaller items, whether it's a tank top or whatever else, and then I put it face down with all the product in there to protect the actual head of it. And then around the brim here, I can just put shoes or any other kind of like loose pieces around here. I get asked at least once a week if teaks are worth it. Teaks are worth it. They serve me so well. I wear them all around the world. They're these Italian leather flats. What I love about them is that you can just fold them up and you can literally throw them into your suitcase. They take up no room. They are a bit of a higher price point, but I think if you were to invest in one in a neutral, you'll get so much wear out of it. It's really gonna be well with your money, both for travel and for at home. So I know Birkenstocks have had their day in the sun and they're not exactly in style anymore, but they are just really comfy. There's a reason why travelers have kind of worn them for years. Get them in white or black. They will look neutral enough. They're kind of a bit clunky. They're not the most flattering shoes, but I can wear them for hours. I've worn this like very dirty now, actually white pair in Greece, in Italy, in Spain. I get a lot of use out of them. And while they're a thicker sole for packing, I just kind of wedge in socks here, and it helps maintain the shape of the sandals, and it's a good way of maximizing all your space and your carry-on. Finally, the one thing that people always forget about, and yet it takes up no space, is flip-flops. So if you're going to go to the beach, you absolutely need a pair of these because it's so hot. You can't just walk barefoot on the sand or on the rocks. And also most of the other shoe options are not the best for walking around on the sand with, because you're going to get sand in them. It's going to irritate your foot, etc. So just pack a pair of flip-flops that take up no room. You can throw them in your handbag when you're there. And last but not least, the one thing I love to do is to really layer on jewelry when I'm traveling. I typically have like my layered necklaces. I like to put on a couple different rings, especially when I'm wearing a lot of the same pieces or they're really basic ones, because I want to keep them neutral and be able to just stick to a carry-on. I really rely on my jewelry to mix up my looks. So I just take a glasses case, it's actually the Sunny's case, and I'll just put in all my jewelry, so rings and watch, bobby pins. The nice thing about it too is most glass cases have magnets in them, so the bobby pins actually adhere to the magnets here. And while I've shared before my top 5 packing tips, I want to just really quickly bring you guys through how I pack everything into my carry-on to keep things from wrinkling, to maximize space, etc. This is going to be a quick time lapse, and it's going to start right now. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you liked that video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and comment below with your favorite packing tips. Any questions you have, I'd love to hear them. And if you're going to Spain, please stop by Tivogabus and check out all the different travel tips that I have for that area. And if you're going to Spain, please head on over to Tivogabus, because I am sharing so much from my trip there, from city guides to what you need to know, general info, etc. So I have so much coming up there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Llega sin esta manera, no tiene la culpa.